pre-rock and roll. We're getting there. We're up to number four. And this is a first for us. Rosemary Clooney is going to be our first song.
Oh, I remember this song.
Do you?
Yeah, come on. Yep, I remember it.
Okay. I forgot to...
find her?
There's Betty Clooney. That was her sister. I didn't know that. Yeah, she right here. Rosemary and Betty Clooney. Did that song, Sister.
Didn't she
remember
do,
they did
yeah.
that? They did it in that movie.
That was in the movie
the White
Christmas.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, anyways, there's Rosie.
Sisters.
I got tired of hearing it three or four times during the best part is when Bing and
Danny Kaye did it.
One of the most popular singers of the 50s, Rosemary and Sister Betty sang with the Tony Pastor Band in the late 40s before her solo career was launched. Rosemary was featured in White Christmas, there it is right there, and several other 50s movies. And after a period of personal difficulties, she reemerged in the late 70s as a successful jazz and ballad singer.
Hmm.
And before she passed away, I saw her do some of the... So she still had a good voice.
Yeah.
She toned it down a little bit.
Well, I remember I went to a yard sale and got a cassette tape of her, the best of, and it was... She actually redid it in the 80s, and it was...
Yeah.
It was all right.
Now, I don't know if you'll remember this or not, but when you and I were doing the reminiscing show and we were doing some of the 50s stuff, somebody called in and requested Half As Much by Rosemary Clooney.
I remember that.
And I didn't have it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, there it is right there. I've got it now, but I didn't have it at that time. I just happened to remember that.
Well,
Half
but
As Much they wanted to hear.
It's
and
been 20,
it was a big hit for her.
It's been
20-some
years. You've got a few more records since then.
A few more, and CDs came out and... You know, I'm back with the old reel-to-reels and the 8-tracks and the cassettes and I don't know what it was before that. Oh, it was the vinyl.
Yeah,
remember the vinyl? This stuff back here, vinyl.
Anyways,
Connor.
I can't even buy records anymore, though.
Oh,
I was going to tell you about that. There's a movie that I saw when I was a kid. I was a teenager, and it was called Friends. And it was a, I guess it was a...
You got a little bit paranoid and lonely because you have no friends? Is that
No. But it was like a French movie. It's like a first love kind of thing. With these two kids. There was a girl that said she was 14 and a half. And then there was a guy that was a kid that was in English. He was like 15. And they got together. And anyway, it was a love story, right? And I saw this when I was a kid. And I thought it was pretty good. I saw that when at the same time I saw Harold and Maude. It was like a double feature at Macomb Theater over there. In Mount Clemens. But anyway, the soundtrack of that was Elton John. And the album was called Friends, Elton John. And I looked it up on Amazon, and the CD, they want some ridiculous amount of money for it. And the records, they could sell those cheaper. But a good quality record is like $49, $50 bucks of that thing. I mean, you think they would come out with a CD? I haven't seen a CD yet of it.
I told you about Chuck Berry and that album cover over there after school session. It's a special issue.
Oh, is that why it was expensive like that, 40 bucks or 50 bucks?
No, it was 20, but it's what they call 80 gram vinyl. It's a special vinyl, and it's a collector's item.
Yeah. That's good Elton John stuff that you don't hear in any of his greatest hits or any of that stuff. Even Friends, which was kind of a mediocre hit. I don't know.
Do you remember the group called A Friend?
No.
No?
No.
I sold one of those 45s for $20, but
I was looking into this whole thing too, and it was kind of odd because this girl that says she was 14 and a half, I mean, she does a nude scene in it.
The 14 and a half?
Yeah, that's what she's
14
French.
And a half.
I didn't do it, I'll do it as well as she did. She's French. She did
it. Oh, that's why you did that by accident.
So, anyway, I'm thinking to myself, now that I'm watching this is kind of like child pornography. Well, anyway, I looked into it as far as the, looked up a biography on the woman. I guess she was 18 when she did the movie, but she played a 14 and a half. And, so I didn't feel quite as bad. But I did find out, though, that she died of cancer at age 53. So,
okay.
Yeah. Anyway, so. I don't even know what the heck brought that on.
I don't know. What were we doing? I forgot what we were doing.
Records.
Oh,
we
Rosemary
talked records
Clooney.
Is
okay.
What it was. And,
all right. Anyways, in 1951, July, she came out with her first million seller called Come On to My House, Come On.
Yeah.
And it was number one for 8 weeks, not the charts for 20
weeks.
It's
not Come On to My House, it's
Come On
to My House.
Come On to
My House.
My House.
Right.
You got a little, what do you call it, rap music back then?
Yeah,
come on, my house.
Come on,
okay.
My house.
Now, hang on a second. This is from the off-Broadway musical, The Sun. That's what it is, The Sun.
Okay.
And Stan Freeman, piano, featured on 3/4. Oh, that's neither here nor there. Anyways, Rosemary Clooney, this is our first time. We've got a Rosemary out here coming in at number 4.
Come on to my house, I'm gonna give you candy. Come on to my house, I'm gonna give you apple, plum, and every god I do. Come on to my house, come on. Come on to my house, come on. Come on to my house, I'm gonna give you figs and dates and grapes and cakes, eh? Come on to my house, come on. Come on to my house, come on. Come on to my house, I'm gonna give you candy. Come on to my house, I'm gonna give you everything. Come on to my house, I'm gonna give you marriage ring and a pomegranate. Come on to my house, come on. Come on to my house, come on. Come on to my house, I'm gonna give you peach and pear and I love your hair. Come on to my house, come on. Come on to my house, come on. Come on to my house, I'm gonna give you east side. Come on to my house, I'm gonna give you everything, everything, everything. Come on to my house.
Come on to my house, come on to my house.
Hey there. Yeah. You with the stars in your eyes.
That was,
You,
it was actually kind of a
this old house. Now, see, this
what I'm talking about? The age songs sound the same.
1954, but see, this is when I was really starting to get into music. But this old house was good. I'm sorry I didn't take music lessons. I can't sing a note. I'm sorry about that. And if you don't like it,
I'll
take my bongos and leave.
No, I wasn't picking on
my
you. Really, it wasn't.
My seats fall apart, too. Anyways, Rosie Clooney. Great voice, and she was pretty good in the movie too.
Yeah,
that we just the White Christmas.
Right.
There. Yeah.
Yep.
Anyways,
and so was his sister.
We're gonna move along, and we're gonna jump up to number 3. And I think number 3, I'll just tell you, it's How High the Moon by Les Paul and Mary Ford, and we've talked about them and the music and the triple recording. But I think this was the best one that they did in the pop field, because it really shows that the ability of that triple track and stuff like that they did. It really was really good.
You know, when they did it too, I thought I saw some pictures of them. He had like a bunch of different reel-to-reel reels in this little closet area. Well, actually, it's probably not any much bigger than this.
Right.
I probably wasn't as big as this, actually. And they just went back. What amazed me is that when he did this, how good it sounded.
Right. Yeah.
Because, you know, you're
and look
using
what they've done
old,
today.
Yeah.
Look, Joe.
Of course, you know, I remember we went to Sun Studio, and that's when they did the vinyl, you know, recordings and stuff, and those didn't sound bad considering, so.
Right. And, I really loved the Les Paul and the music he did. And the other one was a Tiger Rag. Catch that tiger. Remember that? That was a great song too. But anyways, we're going into How High the Moon.
This looks like a live version too.
Well, good, but it sounds good.
Yeah, there you go. Here's
hit
Mark.
It. Here you go.
Moon above, love is far away.
good stuff.
I love that. That was great. Yep.
You saw his hands move the way they moved. I mean,
yeah,
the guy was amazing.
Yep.
Les Paul.
Yep.
And I still say that's the beginning of rock and roll right there.
Yeah. No. Well, we keep telling the kids today that if it wasn't for us, they would. If it wasn't for us in rock and roll, they wouldn't have the music that they got today.
Well, if you watched,
we didn't have people like Chet Atkins and Les Paul and a couple others back then. We wouldn't have had rock and roll.
Well, Les Paul, the way his fingers moved on that guitar, it kind of reminds you of a little bit like the Chuck Berry's and the.
Yeah. I don't know. Take a look at your finger right here. Take a look at your middle finger. Stick it up there. Come on, just stick your middle finger up there.
Okay.
Stick it up there.
Yeah.
That's how Chuck Berry's little finger was.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, he was able to reach some of those chords and stuff a lot easier than a lot of other people were, so he played a great guitar.
Yeah.
Did his thing. Well, anyways.
Okay.
We're in 1951, counting down the top 30, PT and OZ, and don't ask me what that means because it's dirty. And we're going to go, we just did number three, How High the Moon, Les Paul, Mary Ford. And we're going to go back to Tony Bennett now. And another big song of his called Because of You.
I think I remember
he
this
did
one too.
Cold, Cold Heart and just his year. He just. And what else can I say about Tony Bennett? We all just talked about Tony Bennett. So let's hear Because of You. Because of You, the second biggest song in the year 1951, according to the Billboard charts.
Okay.
A song in my heart. Because of you, my romance had its start. Because of you, the sun will shine, the moon and stars will say are mine.
Okay, you belong to me.
Who?
Ah.
Who does?
I don't know.
Oh.
Who dat up there? Say who dat down there. Who dat down there? Say who dat up there. Who dat down there? Say who dat up there. Who dat down there? Say, oh, the hell with it. Anyways.
I don't know where this stuff comes from. I really don't.
What stuff? The stuff you got in the papers?
No, you.
Here.
You. Well, fine. He won't have. Won't know what 1952 is next week.
Yes, I will. I know where it's at. Hey. Okay, we're gonna hit the biggest song of the year, 1951.
And he also had the biggest song in 1950.
And he also had the biggest song last year too. So, which I don't mind because the guy's got a great voice.
Oh yeah.
And it is Nat King Cole. And last year it was Mona Lisa.
Mona Lisa, men have named you. Yep.
And this time it's song.
No. Mona Lisa was number two.
What was number one?
Number one was the Weavers with Goodnight Irene.
Goodnight Irene.
Yeah.
But that's all right.
Yeah.
Anyways.
He's number one this year.
This year he made number one, Nat King Cole and Too Young, and which is also a great song.
Yeah. Here it is.
Of course, he had a beautiful voice, so how could he go wrong?
We're too young, too young to really be in love. They say that love's a word we've only heard, but can't begin to know the meaning of. And yet, we're not too young to know this love will last, though years may go. And then someday, they may recall. We were not too young at all.
Pretty good sound.
In stereo.
Yeah. I was looking up Too Young to see if it said how many people did it. Will you just close the book?
Why'd I know.
You just closed the book.
Premature? I'm sorry. Show's over, folks. I closed the book.
Yeah, it was written by Sidney
here
Lipman.
Here it is. I got it. Too Young.
Lyrics by Sylvia D. Published in 1951. And the first person
and
did
sung
it.
In 1951.
Yeah.
Nat King Cole, number one, 1951. I've got Tony Arden. Now, she sang, too, and I've got some songs by her. Patty Andrews in 1951, who I'm not familiar with. Fran Allison, she was an actress. I'm familiar with her. And Richard Hayes. I'm pretty sure Richard Hayes was an orchestra leader.
Okay, 1950. And then, of course, like I say, I remember it was like a kid, Donny Hathaway pops in my head, but I know it wasn't Donny Hathaway.
Donny Osmond?
No, well, Donny Osmond did it in the 70s.
Okay.
But there was a couple. Todd. What was his name? He was an actor, and that was one of his hit songs. Oh, there you go. Grab the right book.
Okay. Well, we'll just now that we're getting a little
Tab Hunter. Tab Hunter did Tab it. Tab Hunter. Also. Yeah.
Okay. We'll just look it up here. St. Right. Too young. We'll see what happened in the 50s.
Too young.
Young. Yeah. Too young at all. Yeah, the book is closing.
Yeah, because that was four versions of it, and then you had it again.
Too, 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 too much, too old to cut the mustard, too young, Tony, jeez, too young, oh, there's a couple of them in here. Tommy Van, but they've got two different, too young and too young. 66, Tommy Van.
Okay.
72, Donny Osmond.
Right.
85, Jack Wagner, but what it is there's two different kinds of songs.
See, I had it by Todd Hunter, or Todd, isn't that his name, Todd Hunter?
Tab Hunter?
Tab Hunter, yeah. I had it by him,
well,
too.
It doesn't mean he didn't sing it, it just probably means it didn't meet the charts.
Okay.
Okay?
All right.
Which means I wouldn't have it, if it didn't, I wouldn't have it in there either, so.
Okay.
Doesn't make any difference. Anyways, that's the big book. That's the bigger book. That's the bigger book.
I want to see, okay. just for the heck of it, to see if Tab is in here.
Tab Hunter should be. He was a big singer.
He was a singer? I thought he was an actor or something.
Well, yeah, both. Okay. He did cover versions of some songs. Nothing there? It's coming up.
Yep, it's there. There he is. Too young. 1961.
1961.
See, I knew it was in the 60s.
Okay. Just didn't hit the charts, that's all.
Okay. Tab Hunter. That's the version I remember, 1961.
That's Young Love.
I got Too Young, but you're right.
They say for every boy and girl, there's just one.
All right, I put Too Young in there, but that must be what I was thinking about, because Donny Osmond did Young Love, too.
Young Love, yeah. All right.
All right. Well, at least I proved to myself that I was wrong.
You didn't have to prove it.
Yeah, well, you know, I had to end the show with a blunder, right?
Okay, here we go. We just got through 1951. I'll rip them off for you. Number 30, Because of You, Les Baxter. The Thing by Phil Harris was number 29. Undecided, The Ames Brothers. 28, 27, You're Just in Love, Perry Como and the Fontaine Sisters. Number 26, Love You, Love You, Love You, Patti Page. Number 25, I Apologize, Billy Eckstine. 24, Down Yonder, Del Wood. Coming in at number 23, Rose, Rose, I Love You, Frankie Lane. Yeah, that didn't sound too bad.
Not too bad.
And 22, Abba Dabba Honeymoon, Debbie Reynolds, and Carlton Carpenter. It's not Charlton, it's Carlton Carpenter.
Yeah.
Sin, It's No Sin. Number 21 by the Four Aces, Guy Mitchell, Am I Truly, Truly Fair at number 20. 19, The World's Waiting for the Sunrise. There's your first Les Paul and Mary Ford. Sweet Violets, Dinah Shore, number 18. 17, Sound Off.
One, two.
There you go. Number 16, Eddie Howard's version of Sin. My heart cries for you. My Heart Cries for You. Number 15, Guy Mitchell and Mitch Miller. Mockingbird Hill by Patti Page. And number 13 was Les Paul and Mary Ford's version of Mockingbird Hill. I Get Ideas, Tony Martin. Number 12, number 11, Jezebel, Frankie Lane. Coming in at number 10, Tennessee Waltz, Patti Page. Number 9, The Loveliest Night of the Year by Mario Lanza. Number 8, If, Perry Como. Number 7, Cold Cold Heart, Tony Bennett. On Top of Old Smoky, All
my,
Covered
my turn.
With Snow.
Be Leaders. My Love! Okay.
Number 5, number 4, Come On to My House, Rosemary Clooney. How High the Moon, Les Paul, Mary Ford. Came in at number 3, the second biggest song of 1951, Because of You, Tony Bennett. And you just heard the number 1 song of
Too
1951,
young.
Nat King Cole and Too Young.
All right, got some good stuff coming next week, then,
got
too.
Some good stuff coming next week, which is what? What do we got coming next week?
Oh, well, some more Rosemary
Johnny
Clooney,
Ray.
Doris Day, Johnny Ray, yeah. Frankie Lane.
The Hilltoppers.
Eddie Fisher, there you go.
Johnny Stanley with
Debbie Reynolds'
real,
ex-husband.
A good comedy song called It's in the Book. That thing had me split my sides for a long time.
Pee Wee King. More with Les Paul without Mary Ford.
Yep. Meet Mr. Callahan.
Some more Eddie Fisher. Some
yep.
Hilltoppers.
LMA Morris is in here.
K-Star.
Percy Faith with Delicato.
Joe Stafford.
Yeah, Vera Lynn. Yep, K-Star. Leroy Anderson.
Al Martino.
There you go. Holy cow, where's this? Yeah. Oh, all right.
Percy
I'll
Faith, Georgia Gibbs.
All right, we got a good
Four
year.
Four aces.
Coming. 1952 coming next week. What do you know about that?
Time to go get our Jamocha.
Yeah, it's time to go eat. So, with that, folks, PT and OZ reminiscing.
I'm glad you enjoyed us in 3D.
Right, in 3D, and we're going to do our Blues Brothers thing and say that, what did they say? We've got our sunglasses, we've got a pack of cigarettes, a full tank of gas.
And $20 or
and
something.
$20, let's head for Chicago,
yeah,
I guess. Something
like that.
Okay. Elmore Blues. Good night, everybody.